we decided to talk about emancipation, specifically Juneteenth, 19 June 1865. Juneteenth is known as the oldest emancipation celebration in America. That is when General Gordon Granger and Union soldiers, among them USCT, United States Colored Troops, marched into Galveston, Texas, and announced that the enslaved population was free. And so let's really talk about Juneteenth in the larger context. So the Emancipation Proclamation was that proclamation issued by President Abraham Lincoln on January 1, 1863, which freed African Americans in those Confederate states of America, those states which he really did not control. The states that the Emancipation Proclamation did not apply to were the five border states: Maryland, Delaware, what became West Virginia in 1862, Kentucky, and Missouri. So those border states were not a part of the Emancipation Proclamation. But going back to Juneteenth and talking about the 1863 Emancipation Proclamation, let's talk about actually the first known emancipation of enslaved people during the American Civil War. And that happened right here in our nation's capital, where the museum is located, in April of 1862. DC actually emancipated the enslaved population. About 2 years later, in October of 1864, Maryland followed suit. A couple of months later, in January of 1865, the border state of Missouri followed suit and emancipated the enslaved population. And 1 month later, West Virginia followed suit and emancipated the enslaved population. So when you really think about it, Juneteenth, June 19th, is one of many emancipation enactments during the period of the American Civil War. A couple of artifacts which talk to self-emancipation. One is this Enfield musket, which belonged to a private by the name of Walter Denning, who served in K Company 26 USCT, which served in South Carolina during the American Civil War. And this really represents African Americans picking up arms to help free the enslaved population and themselves. A second artifact in our array of artifacts in the Civil War section that I want to key on is the Army of the James Medal, also known as the Butler Medal. General Benjamin Butler had this medal made in 1864 to give to African American soldiers for their prowess on the battlefield. And on the back of the medal, it says, "Liberty came to them by the sword," which again talks to that self-emancipation. Liberty came to them by the sword. So these are just two of our many artifacts which talks about self-emancipation and the emancipation of African Americans during the American Civil War.